Here now, retired Lieutenant Colonel James Carafano, Heritage Foundation Vice President for National Security and Foreign Policy. Colonel, great to see you. Your reaction to that?
Yeah. So this administration's actually facing three oncoming crises in Afghanistan. This is just one of them. You know what the other two are?
Go for it.
So the first one is, look, there are tens of thousands of Westerners in the country. They can be taken hostage. They can be killed. They can be ransomed. It's going to take us weeks and days to get through that crisis, which could dwarf the Iran hostage crisis. So that's just problem number one before we get to the terrorism threat, because it's going to take weeks and months for the terrorism threat to unfold. We're going to have another terrorist sanctuary in Afghanistan. That's a given. So the place where we plotted 9/11, we're going to be plotting the next 9/11. Mm-hmm. But also, the Taliban victory is a clarion call to the entire Islamist global terrorist movement. You know, we have heard the Americans rise up and join us. So they're going to be potentially sparking other groups to come after the United States and our friends and allies. And there's a third.
Please, yeah. Go ahead. Third one.
No, because there's a third crisis right behind that that nobody has talked about, which is the Biden administration has enormously gifted China. China will work with the Taliban, because nobody else will, because they'll be an outlaw regime. China will work with them. They'll build a land bridge across Afghanistan to Iran. They'll have their own economic highway. They'll go right into Western Europe. If the Iran deal goes through, they'll make trillions of dollars. They'll have access to all the resources in Afghanistan, including the rare earths and everything else. They'll be on the flank of India. They'll own Pakistan. We essentially, if we don't do something, in addition to facing the next 9/11, we will have gifted China all of South Asia.
Well, the China problem is certainly, I mean, that's a whole separate conversation. But let's talk about point two just for now, because DHS Secretary Jake Sullivan, he was on today and he was assuring everybody that this is, you know, now that this is orderly and people are getting out of the region. And you're saying we've got to make sure that that happens by August 31st. And there are a lot of questions surrounding that. You know, you saw the people running after the U.S. military planes, the Afghans themselves. They understand the power that the Taliban has there, what they're capable of. And to me, looking at those images, it was so palpable that one false move, one false step, and this could all go, you know, in a different direction.
You know, the Nazis in the 30s and 40s acted like nice people, and they said, don't worry what we're doing to the Jews. Everything will be fine. And you listen to the Taliban rhetoric. We're going to respect women. People can go back to their jobs. You know, Stalin said these things, too. They're going to murder all these people, and they're going to murder them because in this part of the world, honor is power, and you have to be powerful, and you need to be feared. There is no mercy. There is no grace. They're going to kill all these people. They're going to humiliate the United States as much as possible, because it's more important for them to be feared and to be kings in their own kingdom than to have international recognition or be on the Human Rights Council. Hmm. So the bloodthirsty days of the Taliban are ahead. There's no question about that. And we have tens of thousands of people, and we need to get them the hell out of there before this kicks in.
Let's talk about your second point, the destabilization of the region, you know, Taliban working with China, working possibly with Russia, working with Iran. You sit back and you say to yourself, President Trump was planning this, but he was planning to do it in a different way. What do you think that administration would have done to make sure that the region was secure after its exit?
Well, the one thing Trump would have never done is he would never have allowed the United States to be humiliated by the Taliban. I mean, do you remember when the Taliban did that car bombing in Kabul and he cut off dialogue and he just smacked the heck out of them with carpet bombing? Trump would not have been humiliated. And the Trump plan was really to go step by step and go through each province and make sure it was politically and militarily secure before moving on to the next one. So it was never just we're pulling up and leaving. And look, I talked to the Trump people. If they had been reelected, they were perfectly willing to stay in Afghanistan at that number. They believe that number would have been a deterrent. The Biden nonsense that the tsunami was coming and the Taliban were going to overwhelm us. We've been fighting the Taliban for 20 years. They could never do that. Yeah. The Afghan military took 70,000 casualties fighting this guy. I don't think there's any truth to that.
Colonel Carafano, thank you so much. Good to see you tonight.
Thanks for having me.